The Elektor DSP Audio FX Processor board is basically an ESP32 microcontroller with high-quality audio in and outputs added to it. However, what sets this board apart from other seemingly similar boards is that the audio interface integrates the DSP capable of processing audio all by itself. This feature makes the board not only powerful, but also flexible and versatile. This kit is an ideal choice for audio enthusiasts and developers, designed for a broad range of audio processing applications. Let's take a closer look what's included inside the kit. This compact kit arrives in a small box, making it easy to store and organize. As we open the box, we can see that everything is packed neatly. It includes two jumpers, four control potentiometers, two 17-pin headers, and finally the ESP32 Audio DSP FX Processor Board assembled. You'll also receive one ESP32 Pico Kit G4. Programs for the ESP32 can be created with Arduino or Platform I/O, CMake, or by using the Espressif IDF, while programs for the Audio DSP are created with the free visual programming tool Sigma Studio by dragging and dropping predefined algorithm blocks on a canvas. The Audio DSP FX not only serves as a DSP experimentation platform, it also offers a wide range of applications including Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, audio sync and source, guitar effect pedal, music synthesizer, sound function generator, programmable crossover filter for loudspeakers, and much more. It's available for purchase at a special price on the Elektor store. Get it now by visiting the link in the description. You can also find more details about specifications and applications of the Audio DSP FX processor. Now let's have a look at the block diagram. It shows two main blocks, DSP32 and the Audio DSP, connected to each other with multiple buses. The I2S bus is used for transporting audio signals, while the I2C bus allows controlling the DSP from another processor like the ESP32 or an Arduino Uno. This bus is also available for reading from or writing to the EEP ROM. The fourth bus runs from the ESP32 to the DSP and is for analog signals that can be used inside the DSP to control parameters of DSP algorithm blocks. The audio input-output bus consists of two input channels and four output channels. The ESP32 also features a USB to serial converter, and the MIDI input and a MIDI output. Up to four potentiometers are available for either controlling the DSP or for some other purpose. Finally, the ESP32 has a radio for Wi-Fi and Bluetooth communications, symbolized by the internet symbol. If you're curious about the functioning of the Audio DSP FX processor, its applications, and how to get started with it, I highly recommend that you read the description of this project on the Elektor Labs platform. Find the link in the description for more details.